Amy and I believe every teenager and college student deserves to know the love of God. And we know you believe that too, because for 14 years you have prayed for us, encouraged us, partnered with us, and given generously no matter where we've lived in the mission. We know that your heart breaks for teenagers and college students, and you want them to know the greatest story ever told. Your faithful generosity and relentless partnership has impacted communities, changed families, and made an eternal impact in the lives of teenagers all over the United States. Well, in Acts 4:20, the disciples are sitting around and it says, "For we can't help speaking about all we've seen and all we've heard." Well, because of you, we have seen and heard God do a lot, and I want to share some of that with you today. When we started, it was just me and Amy and Anna Gray. Our family grew. We added Asher, Ayla, and Andy Lane, and they have all grown up. We own two homes in Georgia, one in Texas, and a pink house in Florida. We've had club with small crowds and large crowds. We've packed out barns, log cabins, churches, fields, lunchrooms, skate rinks, coffee shops, school libraries, bowling lanes, and corrals. We've been in color wars, shaving cream fights, and launched flower bombs. We've been part of small camp trips and large camp trips to Windy Gap, Crooked Creek, Frontier, Southwind, Sharptop Cove, and Camp Buckner. I've spoken at summer camp for Young Life, Wildlife, Young Lives, Capernaum, and Family Camp. And we have dressed up in characters. Man, has it been fun. Amy and I have had the opportunity to play a bunch of different roles in hopes of bringing laughter so our friends will hear about Jesus. I've been dogpiled, covered in whipped cream, swung from a ceiling, and blobbed miles high. We've been blessed with hundreds of Young Life leaders who have invested in us, our family, and the teenagers in our cities, and we will forever be grateful. More importantly, we have seen lives changed forever. Hundreds of teenagers begin a relationship with Jesus. Jesus said in the story of the prodigal son, the father speaks and says, "This son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found." We have seen teenagers come to life and college students come to life, and we couldn't have done it without you. If you know me, you know for the last 14 years, there's been a part of our Young Life mission that has had a grip on my heart, and it's Young Life Capernaum, our ministry for our friends with disabilities. And I am so excited to let you know that this summer, I begin a new position as Young Life's Capernaum Initiatives Coordinator. Our dream is to provide a leader development program and build an on-ramp for Capernaum alumni to serve within Young Life on a volunteer leader team, a local committee, and hopefully see many transition into a staff role within Young Life. Our friends with diverse abilities spend majority of their life being served. Well, we desire to extend opportunity for them to experience more of Jesus by being more like Him. Jesus said the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give His life as a ransom for many. Will you come with us in the next 14 years as we equip our friends of all abilities, to serve and to give their lives away? Serving as the National Capernaum Initiatives Coordinator is a humbling opportunity. Come with us. Let's build dreams together.
Every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. A million dreams for the world we're gonna make.
It's gonna be a great journey, and I hope you come with us. I can't wait to share all the stories of how we'll see and hear God on the move. Thanks.
All it's gonna take. inside.